Okay, I suppose I better check the dating apps. Let's do some swiping. No. No. Yes. 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 I wonder how they work out these match percentages. It's probably based on all those questions. But what if they ran a simulation to see how compatible we'd actually be? No, that's a stupid idea. Isn't it? In Black Mirror's fourth season episode, Hang the DJ, the premise is everyone's dating lives are controlled by an app called Coach, which sets you up with people and even tells you how long you're going to be with them, if you like it or not. From all the data Coach collects, it sets you up with your perfect match eventually.
And it always finds your perfect match.
In 99.8% of cases.
But as the two characters defy Coach and try to run away together, what we find out is that they were within a simulation the whole time. One of an ensemble of 1,000 total different simulations of that same couple, 998 of which ended up together, which forms the basis of a match percentage for a dating app in the real world, with that 99.8% being a callback to earlier in the episode. And you might have thought, oh yeah, that makes sense, nice, right? No, it absolutely does not make any sense at all. As I was recently explaining to somebody on a date, because that's what you talk about when you're on dates, right? Right? The whole 99.8% thing cropping up everywhere is just a mistake by the writers. And I'm going to tell you why. The most obvious way to see this is to understand that it's a circular argument. If the 99.8% is supposed to be the percentage of all of the simulations that were successful run by the app in the real world, then how on earth does the one simulation that we're following know the outcome of all 1,000 simulations before it's even finished running? What's the point of running a simulation if you already know the answer? It doesn't make sense. Then again, you might say, oh, but we were in simulation number 998. We actually saw that at the end of the episode. So maybe they just used the number of the simulation that was actually running. Which is fine if you're talking about simulation number 998, but what if you're in simulation number 1? Are you really going to trust an app called Coach who claims its success rate is 0.1%? Now, there is one way that this could work. Say, for instance, that each simulation bases the confidence level of Coach on the results of previous simulations. So, for instance, in simulation number 998, it looks at the previous 997 simulations and then takes the success rate out of all of those. That would mean 995 of those had been successful to end up with a 99.8% probability, to that level of precision anyway. But if you've any experience with running simulations, you'll know really you don't want to be doing that, running them sequentially, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's incredibly inefficient. Simulationists will always try and run independent calculations in parallel, essentially using different processors so that they can be done exactly at the same time, rather than taking up a huge amount of time on just one processor. And there is evidence in the episode that that's what's going on when we see all of the simulation couples right at the end. It seems like they've all finished their simulation runs near simultaneously. Another thing to think about is, what about everybody else that's using that app in the real world? Where are their simulations? Are they all running a separate 1,000 simulations, and every other person in each simulation apart from the couple are just procedurally generated non-player characters? I would argue no, because again, that would be hugely inefficient. It would be much better resource-wise for everyone to be running around in the same 1,000 sandbox simulations to work out those match percentages. But of course, each simulation needs to be self-consistent. So if one couple are told that Coach has a 99.8% success rate, then every couple has to be told that. But of course, not every couple is going to actually end up with a 99.8% match rate in the real world app. So another reason why those two numbers shouldn't be the same. And finally, you might just say, oh, well, it was just a coincidence. Well, that's a 1 in 1,000 coincidence, which I am not buying. Look, I really did enjoy this episode of Black Mirror. I enjoyed the whole series, in fact. But that 99.8% thing slightly bugged me, because it makes a mistake that people often fall into when you're talking about statistics. The original 99.8% said by Coach is something of a level of confidence about an outcome of an experiment. Whereas what we see at the end is an experimental probability, a ratio of number of successes divided by number of trials. They're two very different sorts of percentages, and you shouldn't mix them up. Let me give you an example. For instance, say we were running 1,000 simulations, and we did get 998 successes. We could ask the question, well, what truly was the match rate? Whilst on average, it would be 99.8%. It could be ever so slightly different. And with 99.8% confidence, we could say that their match percentage was actually between 98.8823 and 99.9955%. A 99.8% confidence interval on a 99.8% probability outcome. If they said it like that, I might have been a bit happier, because as a physicist, we often have to rely on statistics to draw conclusions, and you really need to get this stuff right. Thanks so much for checking out this video. I really do appreciate it. I would appreciate it even more if you could maybe write down there what you thought of the episode Hang the DJ, and if you think I'm being far too pedantic. Otherwise, please do give it a like and subscribe to my channel to get the latest stuff. And otherwise, there's a couple more videos over there.